Shoulder sideways, smack it in the air. Legs move it side to side, smack it in the air. Legs move it side to side, smack it in the air. Shoulder sideways, smack it in the air. Smack it in the air. Legs move it side to side, smack it.
Hello and welcome to EEC News, where we talk about the most important cultural aspects of the world. That's right, today we'd like to discuss something that helped shape the world today.
You guessed it, folks, we're talking about Australian global economic policies.
Art. Today we'll be looking at the evolution of art, from the Renaissance all the way up to the more modern creative styles of art.
First off, let's take a look at one of the most iconic styles of painting in European history, the Renaissance.
Great idea. Let's take a look at one of the most popular Renaissance-style paintings, the School of Athens.
Ooh, one of my favorite. This painting was painted by Raphael.
I thought you said Raphael.
James, we're not talking about Ninja Turtles. Why do you do this every time?
I like turtles.
Anyway, this painting was painted during the Italian Renaissance, a time in which painters revived classical ideas and styles from the classical world.
That's right, Chris. This style originated from the ancient Greek and Roman styles of painting.
The School of Athens emphasizes the growing popularity of geometric perspective, which increasingly became utilized by artists throughout the 14th through 17th centuries.
As you can see, the 3D perspective creates balance and symmetry by centering the viewer's attention to the focal point of the scene.
This painting depicts Plato and his student Aristotle at the center, both key roles in development of Western philosophy. Pythagoras is also in the front, throwing it back to the height of Greek and Roman influence and culture.
Now let's move on to a form of art that was a response to the Renaissance style of artwork called Baroque.
This movement usually emphasizes deep emotion through a religious scene, often depicting the height of movement with sharp, light, dark contrast. In this painting, David, with the head of Goliath, painted by Caravaggio in 1610, you can see the dark background in comparison to the lighter figure, with a harsh distinction between the background and the foreground.
Wait, what are we talking about?
James, pay attention. We're talking about Baroque.
I'm Baroque.
Dude, are you okay?
James!
Oh, that kind of Baroque. This painting portrays David holding the bloody head of Goliath, representing the triumph of good over evil and common ideology of Orthodox Christian religion.
Let's move on to a movement that came into play over two centuries later, Impressionism. Definition, make them boys go loco. They want my treasure so they get their. Originating from 19th century France, Impressionism led the transition into the new emphasis on changing light and ordinary subject matter.
Ooh, that sounds magisterial.
Why, yes, it does.
Impressionism became popular during the time of European imperialism, placing emphasis on the accuracy of light, as shown in a painting by Claude Monet called Sunrise.
This painting shows the impressionistic aspect of small, thin brush strokes to create abstract images of ordinary settings.
With this movement, painters focus more intently on the light rather than the subject itself. They wanted to display a constant change in light and would often paint the same painting throughout multiple times of the day to capture different light and different perspectives. In this painting, Monet shows a boat on a calm, peaceful river, illuminated by the soft orange glow of the rising sun.
Moving on to our next topic, let's talk about an art movement that was a reaction to Impressionism, Expressionism.
But first, let me take a selfie.
Taking a look at the painting entitled Scream by Expressionist artist Edvard Munch. Edvard Munch, you can observe the emotion that is common throughout most works of this genre.
That's right, and adding on to your point, The famous painting, painted sometime around 1893, shows how expressionist artists often sacrificed accuracy in their painting for the sake of symbolism.
You can also see artists relied on bright, vivid colors and simple shapes to express their inner thoughts, feelings, and emotions. Munch used this painting to show his inner feelings of anxiety and to put more importance on personal meaning rather than technical skill or beauty, a traditional goal of previous artistic movements.
All right, and now let's move on to...
Hold on, guys. I got this.
My name is James Heatherington, and I'm a professional cubist. As you may not have known, I'm a certified cubism expert. I will let you know everything you will ever need to know about the most influential art style to this present day, cubism. First off, let's start with this one. As you can see, this painting depicts extreme abstract qualities using very sharp geometric patterns to create an image. This movement led to the development of leisure activities such as magnificent piece of art.
That's it! I'm done! I've had enough. How am I supposed to deal with someone who couldn't recognize the Mona Lisa but says a cube of art?
Sorry folks, he just doesn't understand the true meaning behind the art of cubism. As I was saying before Chris so rudely interrupted me, the art of cubism led to the improvement of beverage preservation as shown in this image. Finally, this art style recently became very popular and eventually began affecting modern film and music, as depicted here.
Okay, James, I think we've had enough. Thank you for your help. I think it's time to go to the field where we decided to interview actual art enthusiasts on their take on modern art. And while we're at it, to get some feedback for some pieces of art that we have created ourselves, hoping one day to become modern artistes. So let's take a look.
Hi, I'm James Heatherington.
Oh,
this is Kelman, the greatest man in Westlake of all time.
Okay,
love
so
you guys. Do you like art in general?
I do. I do like art, yes.
So, what is your favorite style of art?
Romantic.
First off, what is your favorite style of art?
I have to say the classical art.
What is your favorite style of art?
All kinds of art.
Who's your favorite artist of all time or currently living today?
I have to go with my boy Pablo Picasso.
All right.
I'm gonna have to go with, I don't know, probably Da Vinci.
Probably, who's the guy that cut off his ear?
Pablo Picasso.
Picasso, yeah, I like him just because he had the guts to cut off his ear.
I would say Steven Spielberg.
Probably the boy Picasso. You know, he lost his ear. I can relate to that. I have both ears, but I just feel like I can relate to that.
What can you tell me about modern art, like in general?
Not a whole lot. I tend to like the older stuff better. But I can tell you that I like the way it tries to break the rules.
I think modern art can be very interesting.
You know, modern art's great, and it really captures just the true beauty and essence and just regular things, everyday things.
What can you tell me about modern art?
Oh, dude, just so modern.
Do you like it?
Love it.
Are you love art?
Yeah, I love it.
I think it's a paradox because it's a joke. But at the same time, it's considered art. I don't know, I can't figure it out.
Well, you know, modern art, whenever I think of something modern, I think of like a weird looking shape that's like white or like just kind of plain, like a cool modern house, you know, it's really white.
Okay, do you like modern art?
I do.
You do like modern art?
I do.
Okay, I'm gonna show you some pictures and I want you to tell me what you think of them. Here's the first picture. What do you see?
Looks like cabling for a bridge.
Okay. I like that. I think it's like one of those like rubber band mazes you have to go through, or a laser maze, but you can't explain it.
What do you think about this?
It looks like a bunch of lines crossing each other. Maybe, you know, just, yeah.
Yeah. You like it?
Yes. Yeah, I know. It's very, you know, it's like music to the eyes.
I'd say that this is an interesting point about perspective.
I watch a show called Scorpion, and there's an episode where there's a boy locked in a basement, and there's all these like wires and strings like tangled up for the people to get to him. So that kind of reminds me of that, a really deep meaning.
that's, you know, that's, looks like someone melted some crayons and maybe they trickled down.
What is your initial reaction to this picture?
Someone spilled something.
I don't know, it's kind of cool because, like, that's something like I would do. I would just, like, put some paint in my hand and just throw it.
Yeah.
You know, I'm angry with little paint and chuck it at the wall.
Interesting. Is this the animal art they sell at the zoo?
What does this remind you of? What does this trigger?
My fraternity house after a party.
Simpleness, you know, it's just a, looks like a blue, just a blue thing with a white line going through it, but, you know, it probably means something.
Wow, okay, so Ice Age, when the little squirrel's nut is going down the little crevice, that's a little crevice and the squirrel is going down the little crevice, trying to get his nut. Everyone's just trying to get their nut.
How much would you pay for a piece of art like this? What do you think?
You know, 15, 20 bucks.
Yeah, what if I told you this was worth about $39.3 million?
You know, that's good for that artist, you know?
Yeah.
Put that in my house?
Yeah.
Like 10 bucks?
You know what, it reminds me of Candyland.
Would you be surprised if this painting sold for $39.3 million?
No.
Oh, man. I like the one on the right.
It's like 39 million, I think.
That's good.
Yeah.
So what am I doing with my life?
Wow, that's parallel planes.
Yeah, well, would you know this picture sold for $39.3 million?
Wow.
It's a phenomenal thing.
I have a checkbook. 40.
You know, this one looks like it was fun to make. Just looks like artists took a can of paint, just splattered it all over the place, and
just having a great time.
Yeah, you know, this looks like it was just a real great time to have.
Sort of reminds me of, like, you know, when you step on gum, and then you pull your shoe up and you see the color of, like, the gum in the bottom. But, like, it happens a lot.
Oh, that would be, what's that doodle art that my granddaughter does?
Yeah,
that would be. Like, what do you call it? Etch-a-sketch.
Yeah.
That's a pretty cool painting. I'm pretty sure I drew that one.
That's probably right.
So
that's why.
That's really complicated, kind of like a high schooler's life. I really like the way they use different colors to kind of orchestrate one overall meaning, which is like love, you know, just love.
What do you think about this one?
You know, this is a great piece right here, and this is something that really just, you know, speaks to me and really just draws the viewer in, and, you know,
definitely
just captures it. Yeah, I really enjoy that one.
He really gets it.
Should you guys make that?
James made this one.
I bought more that one, like at least 10 mil.
All right. Something like this.
Okay.
Any? Do you have any thoughts on this?
I mean, it's interpretive. That's really interesting. James is giving himself credit, so I'm gonna say interesting, and I'd say keep it up. Practice makes perfect.
I think it's by the famous artist James Heatherington.
Oh, I think it is.
I just really like the way that he uses the green and the blue. Kind of brings them in together. It kind of tells you it's not too serious of a painting, but it's serious enough.
Okay, how about
Because some of that's a joke.
This is
really good.
This is Chris's.
Yeah. An original.
Yeah.
I like that very much.
Yeah.
It's so moving.
What do you think about this piece of art?
I don't. Sorry.
You don't think anything.
All right. You know, this one is, it's not too much, but it's not too little. It's just the right amount, and I think it's just really just awesome.
When I see this, it reminds me of that one episode from Family Guy when Stewie's on his bed and he's saying, squiggly line in my eye. So it reminds me of the little pupil in my eye.
Oh, Target.
Yeah.
This one's definitely a little more risky than the others, but you're gonna have to let me know what you think.
Okay. Okay, now this looks like a printer ran out of ink.
Can you give a description of what's going on? This one.
What's that painting, the one about the polar bear making snow cones in a snowstorm or something?
The final one. What do you see in this picture?
My favorite students at Westlake High School, there are 2,600 of them. I love them all. And sometimes in the morning, they show up with blank looks on their face.
Yeah.
So hence the picture.
Perfect, right there.
Interesting. So trees processed into paper is art as well.
Yeah. Some call this one, say that the artist actually was painting a polar bear in the Arctic, making a snow cone out of snow.
You know,
do you really see that?
I can see that.
Some say that this is actually a polar bear in the snow making a snow cone. Do you see that?
One could see that.
What do you see when you look at something like this?
Right. Infinite possibilities.
Definitely.
And finally, here's the very challenging one. What do you think of this painting?
Modern art!
Thanks a lot!
Hello, can you hear me?
Hold on!
Hello, this is James Heatherington here presenting to you.
I don't know what I'm saying there!
First off, let's start with this one. This is weird. This is a weird excuse.
Why are you doing that?
What? Just move those papers off.
Can the camera see that?
I thought you said right.
James, we're not talking about Ninja Turtles. I do this every time.
Is that cut?
No,
cut. What are we doing? First off, let's take a look at one of my favorites, classical art. That's not right.
That's not okay.
Art.
Go.
Art. This is so funny. James.
Hello, everybody, and welcome back.
See, folks, it's a lighter. This is a virtual lighter for all your lighter needs. And we're talking about Baroque.
I'm Baroque.
We're talking about Baroque. James, pay attention. We're talking about Baroque.
I'm Baroque.
James, pay attention. We're talking about Baroque. James, come on, dude.
Shut up, it's good. Focus.
You're telling me to focus.
Shut up, don't make me laugh.
Sir, I'm staring at you.
Go like this.
Sorry folks, he just doesn't understand the true artistic meaning behind the art of cubism.
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 Sorry folks, he just doesn't understand the true artistic meaning behind.
So Jay just tried to run down from the hill, and then he fell. That's popcorn. Dude, are you okay? You're so stupid. Jay, are you okay? you okay? Do you need to stop?
G6.